Since I arrived from Colombia, I've been living with Ross's parents. He's trying to save money for the wedding, but for me, it's not worth it. Ross's parents, they were really nice, and they were happy to have us in his place, but it's not good.
Oh, excuse me, pal.
No, you don't have privacy at all.
God.
Amor, breakfast is ready.
My parents are very quiet and soft-spoken. Pau is a little more flashy. Pau is nothing like a traditional Oklahoma girl.
Good morning.
Well, I just woke up and I went downstairs and they were looking at me like, why did she wear that?
You wanna go put something, a robe on?
Good idea.
I can be all day in my pajamas and I don't care, you know? But they have different rules.
Let me go and find something.
Thank you.
They are really conservative, so I was trying to hide because I was embarrassed.
I still have everything in my bag, so I'm sorry.
That's better for the breakfast
better,
table.
Sorry. Oh.
The table, it was ready, and there was had bacon on it.
So, well, we have pancakes, and then my mom made bacon.
Pass the bacon. Please.
You're gonna try the bacon.
No.
Yep.
Why doesn't she not like bacon?
Why don't you like bacon?
No, I don't know. I still.
You haven't even tried it.
I tried it in Colombia, but I don't like it. It's fat, and I can see sometimes like the hair in that thing.
Yeah, well, that's
you don't see that.
Not here.
She'll like it. We'll get her there.
Yes, bacon is very American.
Daughter-in-laws always have that thing that they have to be to learn to cook, either like grandma or their mom of the spouse.
Yeah.
So.
No, I don't know if I can try it.
You can. We'll get her there. Oh my God.
They are really nice people. They are. They are really kind and everything. But 90 days, seriously, I want my own place.
Aziza and I are under a huge time crunch to organize for the wedding.
I've arranged to visit a local restaurant for the wedding reception venue called J. Bella. I think J. Bella would be a great place for the wedding reception because they have amazing food and they have a nice party room that would fit a small wedding for us.
Hey, Joe, how you doing?
Time no see. How you
been?
Yeah,
it's been a while.
Hello, how are you?
This is Aziza.
Nice to meet you.
How many people are you thinking of having?
40, 50.
40, 50, perfect. It fits in here perfect.
Really? Yeah. Mm-hmm. It looks small.
Well, right now it's set. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Right now there's, it's set for 48 right now.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
I think it's plenty of room.
I think that when it comes down to a nice venue for the wedding, maybe Mike and I are on a different page. I have more like girly taste. Mike probably doesn't care that much. I just wanted it to be a little more fancier, I guess.
Isn't it like kind of tied to each other? I don't know.
Aziza had her mind made up, and I don't think there was anything that was going to change it. But you know, I just wanted to try the food and actually give the place a chance because I know the food is amazing there.
Yeah, this is a menu. You want to try a couple things?
Sure, that'd be good.
Okay.
So she can taste.
Yeah, try some of that.
We can taste them. I thought maybe the food would change Aziza's mind.
I don't want to try food.
That's what we're here for.
Here's the restroom. Where's the restroom?
Restroom?
Yep.
It's right through the door there.
Yeah, she's kind of shy about eating in public, so we'll see if it happens. I don't think Aziza's trying to be rude, but I think she can come across as being rude sometimes. Are you okay?
Yeah.
So do you want to try some?
I'm okay.
Huh?
Actually, I'm thinking that maybe we shouldn't have passed out. I don't want it.
You know, that's a pretty standard thing at weddings.
Yeah?
Yeah. You're not gonna try any of it? Like a little tiny bite?
I'm good. It's okay for a restaurant, for like some business lunch or something, but it's definitely not a place for my wedding.
So you don't want to try any of this stuff?
Not really. You just like kind of know that wedding is something like special and has to be like pretty and stuff. And that room wasn't pretty. It wasn't meant for a wedding.
Aziza's been here for 2 weeks now, and we're getting comfortable living together. But 90 days is flying by, and our sex life is still at a standstill.
So
it's kind of strange that, you know, we haven't slept together yet, and we're about to get married. We've known each other now for a year and a half, and
yeah.
Been in love for more than a year, and we've been talking about it for a while now.
Yeah.
So
I think we need to wait with sex.
We were supposed to do it as soon as you got here.
Yeah.
Well.
The whole thing about me and Mike not having sex is I still don't feel completely comfortable because we didn't have enough time to spend together. When it happens, it happens.
I can't wait to have kids with you.
Right now is probably not the best time to have kids.
Yeah. Make sure we're all settled and everything. And
yeah.
I just want to be ready to have a kid when we have one. There's so many women on birth control.
Yeah.
I'll have to call and make you an appointment.
I wonder if the birth control will affect me, like, real bad. You probably won't notice it, but my body probably will.
I hope that the hormones don't change anything with you. I don't really know anything about it.
Yeah.
But
me neither. Never taken it before.
Aziza may be a little more uptight than some American women. I think that, you know, she's just still worried about our sexual relationship. I hope she becomes a lot more comfortable.
Yeah. Aw. Lukey, you're so cute.
He's enjoying it.
For sure.